I think since last year when we had the first waves of COVID, that's, I think, concern number one that we had when it came to the oil market. And I think when we issued our report yesterday, looking into post-COVID recovery, the area where we have, where we see a lot of uncertainty, number one, is actually non-OECD demand. While my colleagues at the IEF post their comparative analysis of data between OPEC and IEA and EIA, there are two metrics that I look at. The first one is, of course, inventories. If we we are at 68 days of forward demand, so markets are still relatively well supplied on aggregate. But the other metric that I look at very particularly is non-OECD demand. And there, between the three agencies, you have, I think, a relatively high discrepancy of in demand growth, which of around 360,000 barrels a day of difference in oil demand growth just in an OECD. That's equivalent to the consumption of a country like the Philippines. So depending on how oil demand will evolve in the next year or so, you will still need to manage the market very, very well if you are indeed an oil supplier or a group of oil suppliers or like-minded oil suppliers. So I think when it came to economic recovery, for the last few months, it was very clear that when the IMF increased its outlook for economic growth to 6%, the drivers of growth did not really change. The uncertainties that we are facing did not really change. I think what has changed indeed is this awareness of the divergence, the divergent paths between in economic recovery between different countries and different continents, and of course the divergent path in the management of the pandemic. So you will have on one side very few large economies like the US with massive stimulus plans. And we can debate how effective the stimulus plans can be in a later session. And the US indeed might end up being the one large economy that become larger in 2022 than it was forecasted if you didn't have the pandemic. You have in the middle the countries in the Middle East and Asia Pacific who are quite effective so far in managing the pandemic, and you will have travel corridors between and Australia and New Zealand announced their opened their travel corridor this week, and lagging on the other side, right. You have those economies with slower vaccine rollout, more or limited effective policy support, and reliance on tourism.